Ça va être
Et là, on
y a des sous.
The name of Allah, the most beneficent, merciful. My dear friend and the legend maker of, from the various college and the respected judges, a very good morning to all. My good name is Keith Fail Ahmad. I am from Islamic College, Valimadi. It is a immense pleasure to me to present a paper highly technical and interesting topic in the and implementation of the e-learning system in a cloud computing. Next slide. So, outline of the talk and the brief introduction of a cloud computing and e-learning and when we are going to implement the e-learning module in the private cloud, what will you get the benefit? And how to build a private cloud from the open source technology and conclusion future work. And so what is a cloud computing? A cloud, we will go to the history. The cloud computing is a new kind of advancement in the field of information and communication technology to accelerate the innovation for the computer industry. So, the cloud computing is a virtualized image based on internet technology to provide resources like storage, network, and software as a service on demand to the users. Next slide. So, what is the e-learning? As the technology day by day increase, the higher education system adopt the technology as the printed book and education material are replaced by the digitalized book, as we call it e-book. And video lectures and animation, and it leads the benefits to us as a greater benefits, enhanced learning outcomes, and efficient teaching mechanism, and also in environment production by the reducing of the use of paper. Next slide. So there is an enriched demand for the e-learning system in a society. So the most of the institution are adopt the cloud computing to provide a better enhancements to the user. So next slide. So the many institutions, they don't have the ability to create and generate the private cloud. So by the help of open source technology like Eclipse to generate and create a private cloud, and ICA tools, and last but not least by OpenStack. So there is some requirement to create a private cloud. There is a Ubuntu 12.04 version, 64-bit server CD, which is available in the internet for free, like open source technology. And hardware requirement, there is a need of two servers and one as a client. One server is as a cloud controller, and second one is a node controller and as a client. There is maybe some CPU of 64 processor with a 2.60 GHz, and the memory is 4 GB as a RAM, and disk space 160 GB for a cloud controller, and for node controller there is a 40 GB is minimum, and the networking speed 100 Mbps. So for steps for implement the private cloud by the open source technology, before going to start the implementation of a private cloud, there will be a need of a mask. What is a mask? Metal as a service. The metal as a service helps to bring the language to the cloud server. And the Juju, what is the Juju? Juju is a nothing but a start or a stop a service on demand on the existing deployment. And and installation is the Ubuntu cloud infrastructure with the MAS and Juju, and install the MAS server and install a Juju and deploy the Ubuntu infrastructure with Juju and deploy the and create a configuration file and establish a connection between one another, and your private cloud computing is ready. Next slide. And how it is done? Based on that, the client is a request to the cloud server by the user authentication purpose, user ID and password. Go to the user ID and password, or go to the cloud server and check by the database MySQL, and response back as a service. For example, in the many universities or institutions, there may be have a lot of branches and a department, and they may be have a lot of many that they need of a software. So they don't need have to purchase and need to install in every system by implementing the cloud computing. For example, I want the Adobe Reader. I want the Adobe Reader as a software service. I want to read any PDF file. So as a client, I request to the cloud server. The cloud server and responds to me as a server for a particular time. And what can the user do? As a staff, tries to have upload and download the notes and the software. As a student, and we can get the notes and the software and download. And examination board and upload results and our application. And as the principal, as admin, upload notice and instruction to the staff. Next slide. Benefits, we are all low, high availability, high security, and high storage capability. Due to the lack of time, I'm going through the conclusion. There may be a future. In the future, there may be a lots of software and platform are going to be addition add in the cloud computing to the include for benefits of the students. Yeah, Ecliptus and OpenStack. From that we can create a private cloud for the institution level within the firewall.
Difference between the websites and the cloud. Our websites we have on the cloud.
Okay, normal website has a
cloud computing.
Yeah. And my topic is private cloud, and private cloud is within the infrastructure, and a normal cloud is by the open source and VMware and Amazon like that. About internet, internet is a international network, so they can access by the anyone server. For example, Google Indian server they can access through it. So like that, in your private cloud, we can access with the help of a cloud server.
Actually, what he asked is, so when I put all the data in this common server, so whether it will relate to the cloud computing or is it a separate server?
It's a private server. The private server is within the firewall.
So as your conclusion, private server is considered as a cloud computing, right? It's a cloud server.
Yeah. Whenever we want to as a public, we can establish a connection as a public.
Okay, fine. So if the college or education is institution is using private servers, so we can call it as a cloud server.
There may be a requirement and a minimum eligibility for the two servers. If it is having, and we can install Ubuntu Cloud Edition. But with that, we can provide.
What is the difference between the two sources, AMD and Intel? So what is the difference between that Intel and AMD? Because one server is using Intel and the other server is using AMD. So where we bring a company.
For just demonstration, demonstrate. Okay. And we can use any processor.
But
we need also
minimum requirement.
Minimum eligibility criteria to provide your private cloud.
Okay, fine. Like I have a college yesterday. Yeah, it's across the world. Maybe 5 girls in India, 5 girls in the US. How do they use this cloud?
With the help of user authentication.
No, you said it's within the firewall or within the internet, right?
Yeah, by the help of internet connection, virtualized internet connection. And by the help of, you can use a Wi-Fi also.
Thank you.
Thanks. Thank you.